the DXRacer F series. Mighty twinger. Please inspect the product before signing. Read manual recently. Do not cut. Head pillow, I think. This is the back pillow. This is the steel frame or aluminum frame. Series manual, tool. Rests, piston cover, some kind of doohickey. L piston. Yeah. there. This metal, plastic handle, plastic. And go there. Sense of how thick, how big and wide the wheels are. It's got the little clipper on it. So you can tell this is a steel frame, which is very nice. Because the plastic frames on the cheaper chairs, they always crack right here when you're rolling the chair around. I'll put the wheel in this here. I'm thinking now. Okay, so the chair has the handles preloaded on them. I don't want the handles on it, so I'm taking those off. Spend too much time on this. What do we got? English one. Pictures. Blah blah blah. This goes here, this goes there. Assembly. Yeah, gotcha. Okay. English. And through there. Through the pads. Good enough. This is the front of the chair, so this means this goes here, does it not? Maybe. Maybe. Core axle goes here. Pretty sure it goes, nope, it goes here. The nice thing about this chair, is that there isn't any, there's no plywood. There's this one metal frame, but it's got these stretchy, stretchy fabric, like in a car seat. And there's your cushion on the other side there. Okay, so if I pop these off. Pop this off. This is boring, 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 boring. I don't want these on here. Show you these nuts here. So each of these nuts, the size of them, they've got a washer and they've got a lock ring. It goes on here like that. This comes off here and then these go back on like so. The only thing that I can see that could be a problem are these tiny metal hooks that are holding this on here. I don't know about those. So these are just extra washers. Go like that. I just screw through here. So how far does he stick out here? These are gonna pop off here. That's interesting. I wonder if I should leave these out. I should leave those out of there. If you're sitting on it, it might poke the fabric. I'm gonna leave those out. They can stay there. They can stay there. Oh, maybe they do need to stay there. Okay, maybe I'll leave these two here. Compress that down. Leave these two out and these two in. FE08-NW, FE05, those are just part numbers, I guess. Uh-oh.
Don't fall.
No. Oh, look at this. I did it again. Come here. Oh, there it is. I found it. There it is. Oh, where did they get a piece? Did you get a piece? Oh no. Got a piece. Oh yeah, this is interesting. So, if you can tell, there's a piece of leather here, and there's another piece inside of here, which this ring hooks onto. I don't know if the camera can pick that up. Right in here. And these screws go in between these two, and you can just barely see it. So when the screws are all the way in, they're not actually touching this other little piece of leather, which is part of the side, which is part of the side piece, folds down and then wraps around here. So this goes here. Because I was concerned about putting these all the way in, screwing them all the way in, and maybe poking the seat, but they should be fine. Maybe I put seat on first. That make more sense. Oh, and this is just free floating. Okay, so that's why that one's going there. This one just free floats, and all the work is on this side. And for the thickness, wow, that's really squishy. Squishy. Oh, sore back. Flip that over. Get that away. See the big part on the outside. So these are just little clips on either side there, and they pinch together. So, click. Putting the big part on the outside edge. Piston slides into here. Just like that. Push the piston, raises it up. That piston just overhangs a little bit like this. I don't know if you can see that. Okie dokie. Back. Oh, that leather's cut. They cut the leather kind of just exacto knife cut it, I guess. There's a zipper here that runs along the edge that folds down inside of here, and then they've got this clip together. See, I'm not sure about the construction. There's a metal wire that goes inside of this fabric, and this metal clip is hooking into the wire. But I don't know about those clips. They seem flimsy to me, but maybe they'll hold up over time. I'm not sure. There's another zipper that's hidden. Goes all the way down on this side. Easily flip that side over. Again, lots of cushioning. Looks like a metal frame on that side. And on this side is the same thing. They just like could cut it with an X-Acto knife. So there's no other parts. So this should just be able to screw those in. Okay, so what's inside of here? So there's nothing in here to screw onto. Right. There's nothing in those holes. So, okay, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get this down here. I'm gonna put this on here. Like a saw. So, I don't think there's any washers that go on there. Pretty sure there's no washers that go on there. Just double check. Just to make sure. I don't see no washers. Doesn't look like it's using washers. Oh, yes, there's no washers. Goes in here like this. You know, if I'm not mistaken, every single one of these screws are a universal size, but they're not the same length. Some are shorter than others. And I mixed them up. Oh, great. Just great. I mixed them up good. Short one, short one, short one. Which ones are these ones? Are these short ones? Feels like a long one. Ah, lost another part. This is a long one. I don't want to put a long one. I want to put a short one in there. Make sure you put the short ones in here, because when you sit down, if you can see inside of here, when you sit down, right, make sure you put short ones inside of here so they don't stick out past this metal piece. This is another long one. They're slightly longer. I'm going to put this short one here. Okay, where's the nut? Where did it go? I don't know. Where did it go? Oh, there it is. I sees you. I sees you. There's you are. Okay. This is a short one. Short stubby. Short one. These two are short. There's this short one here. So what is this here? So that tiny little weld here holds this bar on, which also holds these straps and these together. That's a metal frame, which is nice. Come on, get in there. There it goes. Now, you see, I don't think that's supposed to go there, but the central axis, right where your butt goes, this is where that's supposed to go. So this is hiding underneath this. So I don't know if I put that on right. Maybe I make a mistake. I don't know. I don't think so, because the picture shows it's in the front. So that's kind of weird. Now this is blocking. It's kind of hiding it. I guess it's so it doesn't get caught on stuff. Where's my tool? Cinch these down. Done. Now, this, my back, sore back. Oy. So this is gonna slide into there, just like that. You can see that? That slid right into there like that. Okay. Okay, so back part. Like these holes that they got drilled, it's not a good thing, I don't think. I do not like. Okay, so how did this go on here? Go up here, this hole lines up with this hole. Not quite. This is too big to fit in here, so that's gotta go there. It's got to. There's no other choice. Okay. Now these holes line up. Down, free, lock. Okay, so these are the covers. So these covers, are gonna line up with the holes like so. Okay.
Ta-da!
Use the handle and go all the way back. Okay. That's the assembly. So I'm just going to show you. Get rid of this. Just going to show you the armrests that go in here, like that. I took these off because it's not going to work with the desk I have. Just to give you an idea of what they look like. So it's really stiff. Really stiff foam, hard to compress, a little bit of a curve to it. You can see how big it is compared to my hand. And these lift up, they're hooks, so you can raise and lower it. Big steel plate, a couple screws bolting it to the plate. It's basically what it looks like. I'm not gonna use those. This has got a, there's a steel bar running inside of here for good weight, and it's got some cushion around it. Two fingers on that side too. So right here, there's like a pressure point along the edge of this thing. If I sit back more, it's not quite as much. But if you sit forward, your butt forward, and you have your legs, sit forward and you have your legs open, you can feel it right away. It's pushing on your legs. You can feel the bar. These are all covered in foam. So the same as the bottom of this chair. So the same thing underneath this chair here with the green straps, how they flex. They have the same thing inside here, going strips. You can feel the straps. Like there's one here, there's another one here, and there's another one here, and there's another one right here. And this is stiff. This is empty space where the back of your head would rest. And all these sides are cushioned. And the back side here. So this is your lock and your free. That just controls, you know, the flex, your handle for going back and forth. So the only problem I see is this. Another thing is when you shove it all the way forward, you'll notice that this starts to bind together. It's not much, but it's pretty tight in there. Thickness of this chair.
Did you let him back in here, or is he still outside?
He's outside somewhere. So the thickness of this chair is actually different. This side's a little bit more thicker than the other side. Hmm. riding on that side, I don't know. This is your adjuster for adjusting your spring tension, which controls the tilt up and back and forth when it's in free mode. It controls how strong the spring is. Tension.
little black piece.
Now, if I look at it, it's just like a mangled piece of plastic at the end of it. That's offset from, it's offset from center. And that little click. That little clip popped off of here when I was tightening and loosening. So I want to tighten and loosen. When I was twisting it, when I turned it in too much, it popped that clip out of there. Doesn't quite snap back in. You have to kind of unscrew it, loosen it off before it'll sit flush inside of there. But yeah, these are all flexible. So there's these ring clips. There's a thin metal bar, two of them, that run the length. It's got leather fabric. It's just a piston. So the entire frame is made of metal. There's no wood or anything on this. It's all steel. It's not too heavy, but it is heavier. Got those locked into there. Those just sitting there. And this is that locking mechanism. In and out. Tilt. This is the grab handle. So, it's nice you can grab this. Just lift it up. If you notice, so this is interesting because this is grease right here. You see that? It's got some grease there, lubricant. And if your clothes are really baggy or something, they can see you rubbing up against this here. So that's not a very good design, actually. You got all this grease that could smear everywhere. It's not really a grease, it's like a, I don't know, mineral oil. It's really clear. It'll probably dry up eventually because you're gonna, you know, your hands are gonna be here, you're gonna be rubbing, catching it. But you only see this part when the back is down. So if I lift the back up, see, so this side here will protect your clothes from getting up into that greasy part here. There's a little bit of grease right here. It's a little bit of clear grease. That's not too bad. So for the most part, this will protect you from these gears, unless you open it wide up, and then it exposes them. There's not really nothing you can do about that, but most of the time you're not going to have it like that anyway. Yeah.
So you can see how much cushioning is here. Those are stitched on. That's not a sticker or labeling, that's actual stitching. So that'll never wear off there. It's got a little formula tag on the side here. Yeah, this whole thing is lumped to one side here. Lumped over to one side. This plastic clip has come out of here since I've been using it. That's how it's supposed to sit. It's supposed to sit flush. This one's still in there. So this is flush here. This is flush here. I'm not sure why that popped out of there. In there like that.
sideways like this.